Hi everyone, this is Rihanna from A Frugal Life. Today I'm going to be talking about extreme ways to save money. So some of these are mine, some of these were gathered from our Facebook community group, and I did gather the ones that I've tried before. So in the future, I will mention some things that our Facebook group brought up. I did post a question on the Facebook group asking what are some extreme ways, and I got over 600 comments of people giving us ways that they save money that they feel are extreme compared to others. So I like to keep my videos short. 600 is way too many, so I am just gonna give you 10 of the ways that I save money that I think are extreme. And in the future, we will talk about some more ones. If you wanna share what you do, please put them in the comments below, and I will call you out in a video next time if I share that with our friends or on Facebook or YouTube. So one of the ways we have saved money in the past, we do not do it now because of various reasons, but we have survived for years on one car. So right now we have more than one car, we can afford it. We kind of live out in the mountains, so sometimes we need two cars if I have to go somewhere and my husband has to go somewhere separately. When we lived in the city, however, we were able to have just one car. So for instance, when we lived in Phoenix, Arizona, and my husband was going to school, we survived on one vehicle and my husband's motorcycle. So he took his motorcycle to school and then I took the car to work. However, we have survived on without the motorcycle. When the motorcycle was down, I would just drive him to school or he would drive me to work or however it worked out. We spend most of our time together, so if we have to go to the store or anything, we're going there together anyways. We very rarely go out places without each other. The only reason we have two now is because we do live in a rural area, but if we lived in the city and had public transportation, we could 100% survive on one car. And there are people who survive on no car. So when I was younger and my mom and I lived in San Francisco, there's really no need for a car because of the great public transportation system, and we didn't have one. We went everywhere on the bus. We didn't even have to take taxis most of the time. We took the bus or the cable car or the trolley or whatever they had at the time that was going where we needed to go because we were in San Francisco. So if you live in a city, of course you understand that you probably don't need a vehicle. You can survive on just public transportation. Sometimes it's even faster. In fact, most of the time it's even faster because you don't have to park in the city. If you live in a mid-sized town, maybe like we did in Phoenix, you could survive on one vehicle. There were times even that I would have no vehicle and I didn't want to take public transportation. I would just walk a mile to the library and back, even in the Phoenix heat. It wasn't a big deal. Back then I was younger and thinner and way more energetic. So it of course depends on your abilities. It depends on your access to public transportation. But one great extreme way on saving money is to have no vehicle or to have only one vehicle per family. So if you have watched my videos before, you know this, or you may have heard this on my Facebook group, but there was a time when we downsized from a 3-bedroom house to a recreational vehicle. So we lived in a RV that was about 350 square feet with me and my husband, who are not small people, and 3 dogs and 4 cats. So a lot of animals in that place, but we did it for a specific reason. We wanted to save money. We wanted to be closer to my parents. I went from a 3-hour commute to a 20-minute commute by doing that. So we did sacrifice a lot of things. We had to get rid of 90% or more of our belongings. We didn't even put them in storage because we lived in a place where we could not afford storage. So we just got rid of our belongings. We sold them or gave them away to friends or family or people that needed them. And we just sacrificed, gave away our things, and lived in that RV that was already pretty much pre-furnished. So we didn't have furniture as well. And we saved a ton of money and we were able to buy a house at the end of that. So we did learn that living in an RV with 2 big people and all those animals is not a comfortable thing to do. But we were willing to make the sacrifice. We survived it. It was an extreme way to save money. And if you don't mind living in a small space and not owning a lot of things, it is definitely something you can think about to save money for the future or even as a long-term retirement plan. Oh, so this is something I've been talking about a lot lately, and that is minimalism and getting rid of your stuff. I do have a video up above, 20 reasons to own less stuff, which I think gives the best overview of why not to have so much stuff and why it saves you money. But it is an extreme way to save money, is not to buy a lot of stuff and to really pare down the things that you own. So watch that video, you will see the reasons why, but that is definitely a reason, an extreme reason, that we save money. Number four, and this doesn't have to be all encompassing, is to eat vegetarian. So you can eat vegetarian across the board for your whole family. You can eat vegan for your whole family. You can just have one member who's willing to do it, or one or two members that are willing to do it. So in my family, my husband eats meat with every meal. I only eat meat two or three times a week. I'm down to two or three times a week now, just two or three meals a week that have actual meat in them. I eat a ton of other things that have protein, so don't worry. I eat green vegetables. I eat lentils with every meal. I eat veggie burgers, which sometimes these veggie burgers have more protein than the actual meat that's in the meal for my husband anyway. But it is so much of a huge expense saving in our grocery bill. So meat is the absolute top most expensive thing to buy right now in our grocery store. Having it every meal for every person is crazy expensive. I'm willing to give it up because I don't really enjoy it anyways. And you would be totally surprised if you could just give it up for one meal for your entire family, or just a few meals for one person, how much you will save in your grocery budget. I know it sounds extreme, but it is something you should try. And it's actually not a huge sacrifice if you're not super, super fond of meat anyways. This next one is something you cannot do everywhere. So we can do it because we live in California. Even though we live in Northern California, which is a little bit colder, we still do it. We do not run our heater at any time. We have never once turned our heater on in 3.5 years we've lived in this house. So the reason we started doing it is because our heater runs on propane. And propane is much more expensive than heaters typically run on in the valley that we live on. And propane is pretty expensive. So we do have a propane tank that runs our stove and our hot water heater. And we're able to make that propane tank, which is pretty big, it's like 200 gallons, last for 6 months. However, if we were to run our heater, that 200 gallons would last much less than 6 months. And it's actually like $400 right now to fill a 200 gallon tank. So there's no way in heck I would spend that much money on heating my house. So we do have other options. We have space heaters in my husband's office and in my aunt's room. So my aunt is over 70 and she has medical conditions, and my husband has diabetes and has severe medical conditions. So he runs it rarely, a little bit at night to just keep warm and so that he doesn't get sick. And then my aunt runs it most of the time. But even with the two of them running space heaters at the times that they do, it's still probably 90%, 80 to 90% less expensive than it would be to run the propane heater. One of those reasons is because we do have solar on our roof. So most of our electric energy goes through the solar. And we do have to pay a true up at the end of the year if it doesn't shake out that we cover it all with solar. But it's so much cheaper because we have solar to run the space heaters than it is to run the propane. So you have to kind of decide what's best for you. I'm going on a long time about this because this is very controversial in my group, but please know that we are safe. We are okay. It gets cold. We put on sweaters and it does not matter. It saves us a huge amount of money and it is not something that bothers us, but that is an extreme way, especially if you live in an area that's a little colder, to save money is to not run your heater. So I mentioned this in my last video, if I posted the last video in the right order, was that we wear clothes and shoes until they wear out, especially my husband, because his clothes are a little more expensive because he's a big guy, but he will wear his clothes until they wear out. He has clothes that he wears going out side of the house. Once they get holes in them, he wears them in the shop because it doesn't matter. So when he's just working on things, and then they turn into night clothes. So we just go through the whole gamut of them. We wear clothes until they absolutely wear out before we purchase new clothes. So we don't buy clothes for fashion. We buy clothes for practicality. I do the same thing. I have a pair of sweatpants that have holes in them that I wear around the house. I have a pair of sweatpants that I wear when I work out. I have jeans that I wear when I go out of the house, but we have these capsule wardrobes that are not very many items. They're practical, they last a long time, and we wear them till they wear out. Same thing with shoes. So we don't just go buy new clothes because we want a new outfit. We buy clothes when we need a new outfit. And when we do, we purchase them used, quality brands, and they still last a long time. So that is a kind of extreme, but we're a little bit older. We don't really care about fashion and we're not worried about it. So if you can get away with it, wearing clothes until you wear out is an awesome way to save a great deal of money. So one thing we've done for a long time is to bring our own food and drinks in the car when we go on road trips. So we don't really go on road trips right now because we're in the middle of a pandemic, but we used to do things like go out for the day and drive around and look at great big houses and lakes and take pictures of the nature and things like that. And sometimes we would just drive around for hours. That's also back when gas was cheaper. but when we do go for long road trips like that, or when we go on long road trips to visit my family or others, instead of purchasing drinks or snacks or things at a gas station, we keep a cooler in the back of the car with waters and soda and Gatorade and anything we might need and a pack of ice. And it usually lasts us the entire road trip and the entire road trip back. We just maybe have to purchase a new thing of ice. So instead of spending $20 to $25 on things at the gas station, we end up spending a couple dollars or a few dollars on things we purchased in bulk at the grocery store. So it's a huge savings. All you have to do is keep a cooler in the back of the car, and it's actually more convenient. So you don't have to drive around looking for a gas station or a fast food place to eat when you're hungry. You just reach back into the cooler and grab it. So one of the things I'm going to talk about now is crazy extreme to me, but I learned about it after I met my husband, is that you can make your own tools. So my husband obviously is a mechanic and he has a shop full of tools, but there are times when he needs a specialty tool. Recently he needed an $85 tool to take a specific part off the car that you really have to have this specific tool for, and he didn't want to buy an $85 tool for a one-time job. So he actually took some metal and he welded together the metal with some other things. I don't know. This is crazy. My husband does it all the time, but he is able to build tools himself. So if he needs something to take something off a car, if he needs something to put something together, he will just build the tool himself instead of actually going to the store and purchasing it. If you are mechanical or crafty inclined, you can sometimes make your own tools. I have actually done it for crafts. Instead of buying special tweezers for beading, I'll just use my beauty tweezers. So you can just use things around the house. Back in the day when our grandmothers would use a butter knife instead of a screwdriver, it was sort of the same thing. So make do with what you have. You can make your own tools and supplies sometimes instead of buying specialty tools. And that is totally extreme and you have to have some knowledge to do it. But if you're mechanically inclined, it's definitely something to think about. The next thing I do not do now, luckily, and I will probably never do again because of where we live. But in the past, I have commuted up to 3 hours each way for work. And I did this for 8 years for two different jobs. So we made the sacrifice at the time to move 3.5 hours away from my job driving wise, even longer by public transportation. And I would commute via train and bus to my job in San Francisco. So we lived out in the boonies 3 hours away from San Francisco. I would commute 3 hours in, 3 hours out. And if for us, it was worth it because if we lived where my job was, we would be paying $3,000 more per month in rent than we were paying to live out in the country. So I actually at the time had a laptop with a hotspot, so I was able to work on the train. I was actually able to blog and read and do all sorts of things on the train as well. So it was a huge sacrifice in our life because I didn't get to spend a lot of time at home, but I did make use of the time, and the amount of money that we saved made it worth it because we would never have been able to spend the extra $3,000 a month in rent it would have cost to live in the city. So a lot of people do this. There was a whole train full of people that did this, and not just one train, but multiple trains full of people that would come from the same area to go into San Francisco to work. So hundreds of people, you would be surprised, a day travel up to 3 hours or more to get to work and 3 hours or more to get home. So if you meet those people, give them a hug and some cookies to eat on the train because they're really sacrificing a lot, but they're doing it to save money for their families, to take care of their families. So it is worth it in the long run. Luckily, I do not have to do that because I have a wonderful job where I can work from home now. So that is something that is more prominent now than it was back then. So now I can work from home. So hopefully you'll be able to work from home too if that is something that you need to do so you don't have to commute 3 hours. But if you do, then you do. And that is an extreme way to save money. Number 10, I have an entire video about, I will post a link up above, is free education online. The video up above only gives you 3 sites where you can take free classes, but there are actually hundreds of sites online where you can take free classes. So you can learn languages on Duolingo, you can learn math at Khan Academy, you can learn programming at dozens and dozens of different free sites online. There are all sorts of things you can earn credit for, even for college. Modern State says free credit for college. I will put the link to that down below, but you can actually earn credit for college. You can learn things to further your career. You can learn things for homeschooling, and you can learn them all online. So especially now during the pandemic, when we have to be at home anyways, you can actually earn an education online for free. I would highly recommend looking into it. I am even getting my degree for free online right now between financial aid and things like Modern States. If you want to learn more about doing education online, put a comment in the comment section down below and let me know what you'd want to learn, and I'd be happy to do another video about it. So that's it. I will talk some more about extreme ways to save money in my next future videos. But for now, like and subscribe so you don't miss them, and definitely hit that notification bell.